Christmas season is here. Let's do something fun today. Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. If you are new here, my name is Aga and I'm a CG artist. And on this channel we explore techniques and tools that will help you become a better artist. Today, I will show you how to animate the lights in 3ds Max. I will use a Christmas tree as an example. But before we start, don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you aren't already, share it, like it, it will be a perfect Christmas gift for me. So let's jump to 3ds Max. Here is the model we will be working on today. I have purchased it on 3D Sky. I have already made some modifications. I detached the lights to 4 different groups. It took some time to select them, so I didn't include it in this tutorial. I simply selected every third light and detached them. The model has light material applied. I will be using normal lights though, not material. Let's create a sphere light and match the size. I will increase the gizmo size. I will also increase intensity so the gizmo is larger. Let's make it 50. Now I will create a couple of instances. Great, we can start animating them. Turn on the auto key option and change the intensity to 0 so the lights are turned off. Then go to frame 12 and change the intensity back to 300. Lastly, go to frame 25th so the distance between frames is the same and set the intensity to 0. Let me show you how it works. Looking good. Turn off the auto key option and open the graph editor. To preview the graph, you have to select the lights and click on it here. Click here to adjust the zoom. I want to loop this animation so it repeats the action all the time. To do so, select all the points, go to Edit, Controller, Out of Range Types. Choose Loop and click OK. Working perfectly. Next, I will duplicate the lights 4 times. This time use the copy option. I want to offset the animation. Close the graph editor. Select the second light, select all the frames and move them 3 frames to the right. In the third light, move the frames by 6. And in the fourth light, move them by 9. I will show you how it looks. Great! Feel free to test different animations by changing the offset and the duration of the animation. Now we have to find where to cut the animation. In the graph editor, select all the lights. You can see that the frame 0 is the same as frame 25, so we need to render from frame 0 to 24. Let's change the timeline. Working well. Now we have to add the lights to the model. I will select the first group. I need each light to be a separate object. I will use a script detached by element to do so. Once it's done, use the clone and a light tool to place the lights where the objects are. Make sure you use the instance option. Also, it's very important that the pivots are centered to the objects. Pick the list and apply it. Awesome. Now let's delete the objects. Delete the base light as well. Do the same for the other groups. Here is the effect. Now let's jump to the scene. We need to adjust the light intensity. I will go to this frame, as here the intensity will be the highest. I will add the light to the light mix. I will start interactive rendering and adjust the color and intensity. I will copy the orange color. Looking good. Lastly, I will enable bloom and glare effect and adjust the size. Great, now we need to set settings. I will set the noise level limit. Adjust the output size. We need to change the time output to a range and set it up from 0 to 24, or use an active time segment. And make sure you save the files. When it's rendered, let's open Premiere Pro or any other video editing software you use. Create a new sequence. In the sequence settings, change the resolution and frame rate. Import the images. Make sure the option Image Sequence is turned on. Change the frame rate of the imported sequence to 24 so it matches the sequence settings. Now you just have to copy it and paste how many times you want. And that's it. Make sure you practice it and create your own cinemagraphs. When you do your version, please share it with me on social media. If you want to use this holiday season for learning, I recommend our online courses where we teach you everything about visualizations and animations in 3ds Max. Click here to check it out. Lastly, I would like to thank you all for watching and wish you Merry Christmas. Bye bye! Thank you.